fixing to fix this mess of hair and put on a little lipstick. And we're going to the bin store.
Okay, that's better. Took a little video in the bathroom with my hair all wild. We are driving through Rogers, Arkansas. In case I don't use that clip, or in case you can't hear me over the very loud music in the bathroom. But we just had some tacos. I'm with Mr. Miller, of course. And we're going to go back to that bin store, the like Amazon bin store.
It's Daily Deals.
Daily Deals in Rogers. And it's Wednesday again, which means it's $4 day. We had talked about maybe it'd be fun to look and see what all we could find on $4 day that's, you know, worth maybe 20 or more. Aphrodite's Love Boutique. Well, I don't have a lanyard for my phone yet, nor do I have a GoPro. I'm not holding my breath on that one. But I'm going to do the best I can and film, and maybe Mr. Miller will help me, or I'll film him looking through the bins or something. We'll get some footage for you. So, two old punks signing out. It's Wednesday.
Power steering pump.
Oh yeah?
Just, yeah, set that in the...
Can you do it? Because yeah. I'm kind of...
No, I can't. You do it. Damn it.
You're a nerd. Mystery box. To read anything I can see to tell what it is. Looks like somebody's already opened it. Cozy. Doesn't look like it's worth anything. What's this? Life holder crystal chandelier. Oh, surely it didn't all chandelier. To open them, but if they're already opened, I'm gonna peek. Can't tell what it is. Will be you be my groomsman? What in the actual hair? What's this? AC adapter for something. Mary seasoning. Only $3. Picked over. We're thinking we should come back on Monday when everything's $5 and it's not so freaking picked over. John won't stay with me. I keep asking him to stay with me so we can look at the same bin at the same time.
There's a keyboard with mouth, but it's wired.
Oh.
Biscuit maker.
Oh, cute. Yeah. Cookie maker, cookie press. I like what I already have. Disposable masks.
Yeah, you see them all over.
We have them right now. What's this? Change for cozy life. Balloon. I'm gonna put the corner something. It tells me nobody's gonna buy this great big wad of Amish caramel cashews. Oh, I don't know. That sounds kind of good. Kind of fuzzy something here. Feels like maybe, I can't tell, maybe ear warmers, earmuffs.
Mega cookie.
Only $3. Jeep grill placement. Gotta be careful with this stuff from here though, because I know from personal experience, sometimes you get it home and not all the parts are in it. Which it could be why people, you know, sometimes return stuff. Super Outlet. What is it? Kohl's? Something from Kohl's. What is it? A bunch of plastic bowls. That's fantastic. VVE. Original something. I mean, by Wednesday, so much of this stuff has already been opened. Oh, it's a phone case. I wonder if it fit my phone. Phone case with the credit card and stuff. I don't want mine to be heavier and bulkier. Folgers Black Silk. Oh, they're for Curry. Man, this is kind of crummy. This is neat. Too bad it won't fit my phone. Kind of expect somebody to come and bitch at me for filming in here, but yeah. LED intelligent heater? What does it do? Oh, it's to go down in a fish tank. Yeah, I mean, that's neat. But I just think maybe I'll find some cool nail stuff. I think we're definitely going to have to start coming on Saturday, Sunday, or Monday. Dryer heating element. That might be worth something, but it don't sound right. Probably worth more than $5. A lot of cases, but most of them don't say what phone they're for, so that's unhelpful. Let's go. Replace engine air filter instructions. So it's an air filter. So that's definitely worth more than $3. Might be able to sell that on eBay Motors, but eBay's been so slow lately. Like, ridiculous. Stay Free Max pads for $3. I don't know what that is. I do wish I had John to help me. Well, stay with me. I imagine I'll find better stuff at the Goodwill today than here. Oh, hair. I found hair. Matches my own as well. Oh, I think we may have a purchase. I'm gonna comb that sucker out. Let's see. I'll find another ring light. This is boring. This place is boring on a Wednesday. What's this? Placement ink cartridge. See, I keep seeing ink cartridges, and I can't help but think, unless there's an old used one in there, that those would be good purchases. Hi.
Hi.
You came back. Macaroni and cheese. I think I found a muff. No, oh God, what is it? Did it live once? Oh, I think it's a steering wheel cover, perhaps. Why is everybody over here? Like, literally everybody. Guess where I'm heading? Get away from me, people. Stay away. Just hang at me. He can come find me. What's this? Yes, dear.
I want to go do these already, and you're wasting your time.
Okay.
It's your time to waste, but. What do you think of this? It's not huge.
We already have a bunch of tripods. So that's why everybody's over there, because they've already been over here, right?
Yeah.
This is pitiful.
Well, I mean, this is for Wednesday.
So this is where it's at. Books. I'm thinking nobody's looking at the books. Nobody at all. I'm thinking of coming back on Friday when everything's 50 cents and raiding the books. Some of them are still in plastic bags, and brand new, and sets of books, and yeah, I'm coming back Friday.
I don't know why I got so rattled.
You're okay. So here we go. We're going to the Goodwill. It's a donation center and an outlet, which means it's going to be a bin store. And I've never been to this one before, but from what I understand from other YouTubers, the Goodwill bin stores, outlets, whatever you want to call them, are by the pound. Goes by the pound. Hoping to find, and there's also Fast Track anyway.
FTP.
It's like I'm sure it's stuff from pallets and whatnot, but they will put individual items up for auction. And it only is available in a few states, but man, it's neat. You can get all kinds of shit really cheap. Even if you've got competition on a auction, you can still get such good prices on all kinds of stuff. So let's check it out. Here we are. My first Goodwill bin store. Here we are. Here we go. Definitely don't need a bunch of used sheets. Not today. Hello, I'm on a pound. Hello, everybody. We just got back from our little shopping trip. John pooped out this time. Usually I'm the pooper, so to speak. Sorry, we rode with the windows down. I stopped at Dollar Tree and got myself hairspray and clips and an attractive scarf so I could go with the windows down. It's almost 80 degrees here today on March 1st.
March 2nd.
Oh my gosh, my sister's birthday is tomorrow. And I don't have her card in the mail. I gotta be sure and call her. So, happy birthday, Lorelei, in case you see this. So this place is a gigantic mess, and honestly, it is a lot. We're messy people. I've said that before. But since we have been trying to broke a nail while I was digging through bins, it hurt. But since we're doing eBay stuff, it is extra cluttery. Neither one of us are very good at organization, and we honestly just don't have room here. But we're making it happen anyway. It turns out Friday now, instead of 50 cents, they've changed it to $1, which is a shame because I would like it much more if it was 50 cents. I could go and get the books. I still might, but I'm going to have to really check them and see what they're worth. Okay, there was this, and it made this noise, and it says it's a gold pendant light shade, which probably means it doesn't have, and it's so thin too, I'm sure it doesn't have what do you call it, like the outlet in it, the thing you put the bulb in. This is just this. And I could just see enough of it that it made me think it might be cool. I did not have them open it in the store. Let me lower this just a little bit. I did not have them open it because, I don't know, I wanted to see what it was like. I wanted a surprise. Let me straighten my Frankenstein faces. There we go. And open it, shall we? I'm going to unbox this. I'm trying to. It's got a lot of tape holding stuff in. Come on, Alyssa. Well, the rattly things look to be plastic, but that doesn't... No, they're... What are they? Yeah, they're plastic. Ooh, hey, this is really pretty. Look at that.
Ooh.
$3. Brand new in the box. That's really pretty. Isn't that great? I just knew it felt kind of heavy and the way it rattled. And I looked in and saw a little bit of these. And I figured it was going to be like kind of like this. Got to get everything straight here. But yeah, cool. I think I can probably easily sell that for maybe 25. It's very heavy. Good grief. I think maybe 25. We'll see. Let's see. What else did we get from the Amazon bin store?
Yeah, where's that other?
This is a thermometer. It is a like meat/cooking thermometer that John found, and he knew it was going to be really helpful for him. It looks like a spatula on the end, John.
I know, that's why I wanted it.
I don't understand. What do you... You can't poke at meat.
You can use it. Let me see it. They're probably wondering when I'm going to get to boy up there for them.
I did purchase what we now call the Merkin. It's a whole hot mess and needs to be combed through. And I don't know how I'm going to attach it to my head. I just don't know. I just wear it like that. Maybe I'll sell it because I don't know if this is a look that's going to work for me. What do y'all think? Comment down below. And y'all, I swear to God, on the way out. Well, I knew I was born for something special. Right, this thing has been missing for hundreds of years, thousands. I don't have a good understanding of when it went missing, but I found it. I found the Ark of the Covenant. Here you go, world. Oh God, I looked inside.
Your eyeballs ain't melted.
Eyes.
It's so small, I think it just will cause a little bit of irritation.
Minor conjunctivitis from looking in the tiny Ark of the Covenant. I'm going to open it.
Well, you're really rolling for it now.
I know. I couldn't help it. I had to get this crazy thing. There's the lid with the angels. And I'm not sure what that's for. Something with, looks like roses on it. I guess it goes with it. And there is this piece. It's like a Torah, I guess.
Yeah.
Where does that go?
No, that goes inside.
Oh!
That's the pieces of the original.
Okay, and there's like a little container sort of a thing. Where does that go? Is it broken? Oh, don't tell me it's broken. So, I may pop this on eBay, see if anybody wants it. If they do not, then I'll be gifting this to my father. Now, the Goodwill bin store stuff, there's an awful lot of it, and I don't really know if anybody's going to be interested in looking. But I was trying to find things that were summery, tropical, swimsuits. And I found this men's shirt. It's PacSun Los Angeles. And it says Dia de Muertos, Day of the Dead. And isn't it kind of cool? Yeah, it's tropical and it's got skeletons on it. I wish I could have found 100 of them because that's awesome. And I found a lot of, even though John and I are not terribly athletic and we don't wear athletic clothing and it's not really in the, I would like to just carry much funky stuff, but this stuff supposedly sells and it's getting to where people are wanting to get out and exercise and run around and show their legs. So this belonged to Emmy Short at one point. These are Emmy shorts, I suppose. Just some little purple shorts and I think they're dry fit, I think. Or did I buy? No, yeah, they're Nike. Nike dry fit. So got lots of dry fit stuff. I won't bore you. More dry fit. picked up bright summer vibe clothing. Is this Torrid? No, this was Old Navy, but it's really pretty. I guess it's supposed to be a cover-up, or you could wear a tank top under it. It's very sheer, and I'm sure very cool to wear. We'll have all this stuff up eventually. Now this, I didn't look the brand up. Lawrence Kazar, New York. It may not be worth much, but it's just a really pretty, heavily beaded dress with shoulder pads. It's so pretty. I thought somebody would enjoy that. I found a brand new Kansas City hat. Did you see this?
Yeah, little bitty.
Is it? Yes, it is. It's for kids. It's that 3930 brand, but it looks never worn. It's still got tags on it. Yeah, so $20. The original, it's got all the tags, so that will be good. I found this cute thing. It's kind of a tie-dye, but it's like pants, very wide-legged. What do they call this? A jumpsuit or jumper? In England, a jumper is a sweater. It's got these strappies, and it just looks like the most comfortable, wonderful thing to wear around for spring and summer. Oh yes, please do open windows. Drink local at Stone's Throw Brewing. Not only good for you. I liked it because of the vintage graphics on it. I'll admit, I don't know if anyone will want it. Where's my tissues? Picked up this little thing. Again, I think it's supposed to probably be a cover up. Moon tea ice? I don't know. It's just a nice little lacy. Again, it has some fringe at the bottom. I thought that it would be nice for cover up or over tank, or you can ride around your house in it for all I care. Found a little pair of Liza Minnelli sequin shorts. Little hot pants shorts. There's the front. Zip up. Size. So we could be doing this, if we had prices set, we could be doing this on Whatnot. Talking about the clothing and sell it live. It's Express brand, size 4. I've never heard of Express, but that doesn't mean anything. I don't know anything about clothing and clothing brands. I just know cool stuff when I see it. And I know quality when I look at it and feel it.
Me too.
And John too.
I've been knocking them out of the park here lately.
He has been. It has sleeves. It's just a cold shoulder. It's got this nice little embroidered trim, and it's a black gauze. I imagine it's cotton. Time and True, size large, 12 through 14. Rayon and polyester. Well, it feels like it would be cool, and it is kind of see-through. I wouldn't wear my white undies under that. I'll just put it to you that way.
Yeah, you wear your black ones and everybody talks.
You see the way she was dressed?
No, you can't see black ones under it. It's white ones that would show through it. This is just a little cover-up, just a little jackety cover-up thing. Again, it's very sheer and lacy. And it is also stretchy. And it is Littles, leopard print.
Littles, square hip.
He couldn't run out of the room fast enough. This is power. When you have a cat, you're in control. If you can find it and reach it. Anyway, this just has a little short sleeve. And that'll go up for probably 10.
Here's some nonsense for you.
I can't figure this out. Okay, this swimsuit is black, white on the inside. It's got a little ruffle on the sleeve. It has some little slightly padded cups. And on the back, it has a lace-up back, and this is a size. I tried to check everything before I left the store with it to make sure I knew what the size was. I don't see a size in this, though. I will just... Shoot, have to do some measuring before I put it up. I hate that.
Wow. Work.
So it's just a little pair of shorts, tropical, tan and white. Not swim trunks, just shorts. Lee brand.
Here.
I can't read it. One tame fit.
Knockoff.
Another 14 medium. I don't think they're a knockoff. It's the authentic Lee brand logo, spelled correctly and everything. I have some jeans I got at a Dollar General years ago, and they're LEI jeans. I've got pretty good jeans. They don't do anything special for my butt or my body, but they're dark and still in good condition. So these, I don't know how much. We'll figure that out. I don't like to charge a whole lot. I want to make enough money to make it worth my time. Now these are brand new with tags. New mix. Brand, it says one size, but I mean, come on. You can only stretch just so much. Y'all want to see me try to put these on? You don't want to see that. But they stretch some. And I'll do some measurements. Got lots of new tags in them. Says extra large, so probably XL is about as big as it's gonna wedge into that. You just finish that. I don't remember. Oh, John found this little crop top.
Hollister.
Hollister is the brand.
Hollister brand.
Hollister, yeah. It's a small. It's kind of worn. I see pills and stuff on it. We might get $5 out of it. So I need to count everything up and figure out how much we spent, because at the Amazon place we spent $20 $23 at the Ben store, and at the Goodwill, they, of course, like I mentioned, it's by weight. And I just roll your card up on a thing and weigh it, and I need to count everything so I can figure out approximately how much we paid per piece, because we paid 27 at that store.
No.
26?
Yeah. No, 29.
Okay. Something like that.
Hang on. I bet I can tell you.
I think this is one John grabbed up because it's got the new tags. It's brand new, even though it's been rolling around a Goodwill store.
It's still got tags on.
And it's in beautiful condition. I can't tell what it is.
It's like a throw. Like a... like
scarf?
Yeah, not a scarf so much as it.
I don't see sleeves in it.
Yeah, no, it's for, it's, like you for, know.
At the beach and stuff, to put around you.
Or whatever, you can wrap.
My finger
wear
just.
It over your shoulder.
It's got a hole, my fingernail just went into it. Damn it.
No.
Gotta check stuff really thoroughly and hold it up to the lights in there. Damn. Well. I don't think I can even fix that. Little hole there. Right there. Maybe I'll just use it. I don't mind, but I don't think we can sell it with a hole in it. Dang it. You know me and my scarf obsession.
You just shut up. I didn't notice it, and I looked that thing over really well. So, I don't know.
Foiled by static cling. I look like Mother Teresa.
That mean old bitch.
Yeah. I picked this up. It's just a little crappy top like what you might wear. I guess some girls would wear it with jeans. If it were my size, I'd wear it with a skirt. It's very pretty, very thin, very... We may find more holes and things as we go along. I tried to check everything in the store, but I was moving fast. I was trying to cover a lot of territory in a short time. Was John. Dry fit stuff. I don't know if John saw this that I picked up.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What size is that?
It's got gray stripes on the shoulders.
That's
two stripes.
What size is it?
I don't know yet. I'm showing the item. Get people's mouth watering for it. Super Mario size large.
How much do I owe you?
If it doesn't sell, I'll give it to you. If it doesn't sell in like a 2 month period.
Okay. All right.
I picked it up because I thought it would make us some money, dude. my dude, if you love it and it makes your heart so happy, then of course you can have it. Absolutely.
I love it. It makes my heart very,
it's
very
your
happy.
Payment for taking me shopping.
You love me back.
I do, see? So here's this little sweater.
Sorry, y'all.
Just a cardigan sweater. Got long sleeves. I like how they look. I wish my nail hadn't broken off. This is my business finger. Don't read anything dirty into it. But
well,
I could use my phone if I wanted to. I could do that without too much injury. I can, you know, use the card thing at the grocery store. Because with long nails, I've been stuck where I couldn't put in my PIN number and somebody had to come around and put it in for me. So, but this has this really cutie ruffle. I don't know if you can tell in this lighting, but it's got a little ruffle all along down the sides. Not quite the right season for that, but I guess a lot of parts of the country, it's still...
Actually.
Oh, it looks perfect on you.
See, I told you.
I love you. I love you. I'm glad that makes you happy. And here's another pair of pants. These did have the tags with them. I don't know what happened to the tags. May have fallen off. But it did have...
New.
There it is. There's the new tag. And it's also Nadine West, like that other pair. And they are a size... They're made of polyester and spandex. Hand wash cold, hang dry, size, plus size. And then it says extra large on the store tag. So.
Are those bones?
No, it's not. I think it's supposed to look like rope or.
Oh.
I don't know. It's just kind of abstract, but they're very soft. They're soft like Lulu. Oh, I call them Lulu Romans. She used to be on Hee Haw. She was the fat lady on Hee Haw. I admired her. I tried to go meet her one time. She was snotty and talked at the church and then ran away where nobody could say hey to her. You met the twins?
Yeah, they were actually pretty nice.
They were very cute.
I was an asshole.
Talking about the boys, right? Yeah, they were very cute, even though they're kind of bald. Bald can be sexy.
I was a pain in the ass.
So this is a Torrid size 1. And it is this crazy, what would you call this? Sherbet orange, right?
Fuchsia?
No, it's not fuchsia at all. It's a hot neon peach.
Neon peach, yeah. that's probably as close as you're going
to
get.
And it feels so good. And it's 2 layers, y'all. It is, I wish I had something to... way to show you better. It is, it's almost like, it reminds me of a little negligee, like the kind of little 90s from the 60s, 50s and 60s. It had the very thin chiffons, little layers of the chiffons. That's cool. I wish that was my size. It's very flirty feminine. I need to look this brand up, but this is one called Bando, and it sounds familiar, and I feel like I should know it. This is an extra large. It is very strange, this shirt. This stuff says multitasking is key, and there's a dot, an 01, and the sleeves, one of the sleeves has something on it.
The one up against your chest.
Yeah, okay. There's print down here. It says silent generation, using technology at higher rate than people from other generations. That's what I say, although maybe that was our generation that said that. I don't know. I don't know how old this shirt is. This says, add age, multitasking is key, and a bunch of numbers. And it's just very peculiar and different, and I like that. And this sleeve right here says activism, and it talks about activism. And it seems like kind of a very haughty shirt. With lots of strong opinions, but if that's your thing, there it is. This, I'm trying to start buying swimsuits. I think a lot of people are skeevy about wearing the bottoms of used swimsuits, and I don't blame you. Although some of the ones I saw looked pristine, brand new. But for sure tops, because you can very easily go into Walmart and buy the bottoms in whatever color, right? Black would look good with this. Pink would look good with this. The trim is... forget the big brand that has the kind of flower logo. Y'all know what I mean? Who does that? I don't know. It's supposed to have that little designer flair, though. And this is just the top. Just the top. And it is, this, the brand is Arizona. The size is large. No bottoms, just top. Go to Walmart and get the bottoms. Dry fit.
Hey, where is that other,
little cute short shorts. John found these. Some little boho girl will love this summer. This is a size 12. If you know any little boho cutie or little country cutie that would like to have these and show their hiney out the bottom, there you go. I guess John picked these up, but they're Banana Republic shorts. I'm imagining they're women's because they have that little detail there in the middle. That's awful cute. And these little tiny cute useless pockets. Wait a minute. Those aren't useless. They're deep. I beg your pardon. And these are in a size 8.
I found a lot of size 8.
You didn't in Indonesia. I know. I found a lot of that smaller stuff too. Maybe it's picked over and all the fat girls came and got the good stuff. This, I don't know if I could even fit it into the frame. It is a coat. It's got some stuff on it, some white stuff, but when I scratched at it, it just powdered and came off. So we're going to just use a moist cloth or maybe a little fingernail scrub brush and get this clean. It is a puffer jacket. It's nice. It feels like it would be extremely warm. It's got big snaps. Look at those. Can you tell? Really big, deep snaps. So those ought to stay done. Once you snap them, they're going to stay done. This is London Fog brand in a medium. It's got a regular flip collar, and underneath it, it's got a ribbed, doubled, knitted collar underneath for warmth. Seal that deal. Right? Has a hood. Does it? I don't think so. No hood on this one.
Oh, okay.
No hood, but that's freaking awesome coat right there. I said, no more coats. Let's not buy any more coats. And then I kept finding cool coats.
Yeah.
Found a gorgeous leather coat, brown leather. That thing was sexy.
I thought I should have just got it anyway.
I almost thought about doing it, but notice last minute, right here in the cup, it looked like a dog had been chewing at it. Here's a simple little swimsuit. It doesn't have any straps. It's got a little, these little funny double flap things, I guess just for modesty. Make you feel a little less naked. And this is a one piece. It's got a little built-in patty bra thing. This is a size large.
Calvin Klein hoodie.
Got a Calvin Klein hoodie here. Pre-ruined, as you can see, pre-bleach spattered. Makes it more fancy. Oh, I hate rich people sometimes. That's the stuff that made us feel ashamed to be alive. Being a poor kid growing up, and your clothes are all messed up and have holes in them and bleach stains, and we felt ashamed. It makes me mad sometimes when I look at this stuff that's made to look worn out and old and shabby and paying so much money for it. But I'm not going to cry. So here's a pair of men's polo Ralph Lauren summerwear, I think that's swimwear. Got a cool tag. Look at that cool tag.
Yeah, we gotta look those up.
And there's a pocket in the back, so you can store some crap back here. It has a button on it and a little vent hole down here, so your pocket will stay cool.
So
they feel nice.
When you get out, it, the water don't cool it.
Yeah, feel it. It's a really nice feeling fabric.
Yeah.
And it's got all this stitching all around the waist. It's got these three lines of stitching. Got this little drawstring.
It's Ralph Lauren. Come on.
Yeah.
Quality.
I got another swimsuit. Clothes are really piling up over here. I got another swimsuit. This looks like something my Grandma Tootie would have worn, which to me is a good thing. It's very cute. It really does look very 60s. And it is a one piece. There is the crotch, and the crotch is black, but it looks very clean and smells fine. The tag is a little bleached. It says, oh no, it's not, or something in front of it. Beach Bell swimwear. And this is a size Okay. S4A. So if you wear a size S4A, come on up. No, size 18. It's an 18 women's. I thought it looked chunky. Which one of you curvy girls want a cool retro looking, it's newish, but a retro looking one piece swimsuit? This is a skirt that's either been made to look like it's made out of t-shirts, or maybe it's actually been made out of t-shirts. But it says all kinds of different things. Without all women, wait a minute, no. With all women, march on Washington, something together. I don't know, I'll have to look at it closer and see what all, this is a small, I believe. It looks, no, it says extra small, but it really doesn't look that small. Again, I'll be taking measurements of that. This is what I should be doing live, doing these talk-throughs live. Little girls, very new looking My Little Pony t-shirt. I'd send it over to Pete's, but I don't think he'd fit in it.
No.
I looked this one up, actually. I didn't look everything up. I just went on instinct. But this is Jamaica Bay. Size 1X women's shirt. I need to button it all up, and I'm going to order some mannequins today so our clothing will look nicer. It's kind of fitted. I don't know if you can see, but it's got these seams right here that'll make it fit nice in the back. And it's got this great, ooh, I love florals on black. If it ain't on black, I'm probably not interested. This is so pretty. It's not roses, y'all. Not every pink or red flower is a rose. I see several kinds, like maybe chrysanthemums and some sort of vining. What would that be, John, right there? Petunia?
Yeah.
Petunias. Just various pretty pink flowers. I can't quite reach everything. I snagged this coat. It is quite vintage, and it's going to make us some money. Ooh, is there something in the pocket? Usually I check pockets to see if they left us any weed or money. Womp womp. This does not look like a gentleman who would leave weed in his pockets, though. Although, you really can't ever tell. It is scratchy. It's a brown on brown houndstooth with a brown, I'm not sure what fabric. It feels velvety. Maybe it's a suede. Trim on the collar. I haven't checked to make sure all the buttons are there, but it looks like all the buttons are here. There's an extra one. There's still an extra one in there. That's neat. This is a satin line, satin lining. It has a huge tag. I told John the bigger the tags are, the better the brand. Looks like it belonged to James Todd at one point, or maybe it was meant for him. I don't know, but it's Lakeland Sportswear. Styled in Wisconsin, size 36. Excuse me. And from the look of the label, I'd say it's atomic age, which is, you know, mid to late 50s somewhat into the 60s. It's a really cool design on the label.
And for all you Fallout fans.
Yeah. That's
a dandy coat.
See, I didn't know that, but. Because you play it, I don't, but I see you playing it. And see, that's something we should put in the title.
Yeah.
Right? Like that one coat, although it hasn't sold yet, that I put a Fight Club in the title. John found this really beautiful long sleeve t-shirt. I wish my light wasn't washing it out so very badly. Beautiful rainbow design. And on the sleeves, it says... I know, I'm trying to make it says proud. Proud. I thought it said pride. It says proud, but that's okay. We get it. And the other sleeve, it says the same thing. This is a size large, European large, UK large. Cannot read the tag. It's black on black. I think it says HM, which that's a good brand, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a very nice feeling shirt. It's very soft. It's not a crispy, hard shirt like some. This one I'm wearing, it's kind of like that, but I think it's mostly because this stuff. John found this one, but I bet it's going to sell immediately to some old white man with terrible taste who likes to play a lot of golf. This is a size medium Reebok golf shirt. Same guy that's buying the hat. Maybe we'll get this. This looks like something my grandpa would have worn for sure. He loves stuff like this. Absolutely, my grandfather.
Yeah, that's horrid. I'd never wear that.
Well, that's why there's different kinds of clothes. Not everybody's going to like everything.
But I like the style of it. I think somebody will buy it.
It makes me miss hugging my grandpa. Now I'm going to cry. It makes me miss hugging him. So, here you go. Maybe somebody will buy it and give it to their grandpa. Now, okay. Ozark Mountain Tap Room, Arkansas on tap. Eureka Springs. Drink local. And I thought somebody would think that's fun and get it. I just drop on the floor. Very similar to the one I just showed you, but this is another one John found. It says one step. I'm reading it upside down.
One step.
One step Polaroid capture and remember. And it's got the traditional Polaroid rainbow colors.
Littles.
There's something about Polaroid.
No coats.
No coats. So we come home with all kinds of coats. Well, we understand that they have tremendous value. A lot of people don't seem to realize that. Tremendous resale value. This is just a little navy blue lace. Just something to slip into. It's not burnout. It's lace. But it's just like just a little robe to go over your 90 or you run around in the bear in it. I don't care. I don't know how much I'll put on it. Probably $10. It's really nice. Pretty little piece. But it doesn't have a tag in it or anything. I decided I'm going to be buying a lot of the women's clothes because a lot of what I find is not expensive brands. Women like to get clothes new really often, so they don't want to put a huge amount of money into it. So where men want to get classic staple pieces and then buy new like t-shirts and jeans. But
these are very good shorts.
Yeah, see, and men's clothes tend to be made better, too, because I think the manufacturers know they want to keep them for their whole lives. If you can.
And some of us want to be buried in specific things.
Right. So, I think a lot of the people that come in there, especially women, and I don't mean to be sexist, but they're maybe looking for pretty stuff and not big, heavy brown men's coats. But we've had some very good luck. We sold a Cabela's coat that we got for $15, right?
Yeah,
$15 at a thrift store, and we sold it on eBay for $250. Yeah. And we saw somebody sell one for over $400 not long before we put ours up. So this is very nice. It's a very rugged, heavy duty. Like this is a working man's coat.
And we paid most of the shipping.
What?
And we paid most of the shipping.
Well, that was our folly. But that's okay. On something where you're making that much money, I feel like if you have to kick in an extra 20,
that was about what it was. We got to pay my mom back.
Oh, yes, we do. Faisant l'impossible. I can't read all this. It's like a freaking novel written on the damn tag.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Aeropostale.
Look at that garbage. But it's Aeropostale.
Aeropostale.
And it's a large. So if you know any big dudes that want a nice, heavy, really good coat, then there you go.
Tracking.
So that's about what, I think that's all we got. And I won't count your thing. I won't count your shirt in it. And I won't count this scarf. But I'm going to count all this stuff and figure out how much I spent on each thing. And I'll just add it in later. So that's from our shopping trip. I hope I can get this edited down so that it's watchable. That's all. Let you know next time we do this.
Me,
that's all,
folks.
Bye.